Greetings, hello, welcome back to some more BattleTech and the third and probably final mission of the Kellhounds Flashpoint. Morgan, you're here. After all these years, you can't imagine how gratifying it is to see you on the other end of the battlefield. You promised to release Tempest and Megan. I expect you to keep your word. It's already done. As we speak, a drop shuttle carrying your axe and child is on its way to your dropship. On my honor, I swear that it is so. In that case, you've got your fight. And Gartry, show me what you learned.
All right. Keep your eyes open and watch your sensors.
Yeah, what's that? Radiation fields? Do you have any indication of where the enemies might be? Not really. Whoa, hang on a second. Large pulse laser. Bunch of medium laser plus, all plus 5 damage. An LM plus plus with increased damage. Alright. He's no ordinary battlemaster. And what do you have here? Is that sensor lock? Okay, let's keep you
Keep it back, boss.
A second. Ryan with double PPC and LM, okay. I totally know how to play a sniper mech, don't worry.
Roger.
Alright. No, there's nothing here.
Got it.
Okay, there's a little indicator. It's pretty far away. Okay. It's also nice that they have this. Oh, Rox is a lady, okay. That we have all these energy weapons on the mechs that we got here.
Position confirmed.
In the lunar environment where.
Coordinates received.
Let's just say energy weapons are not the first choice, I'd say. Might have some heat management issues.
Heads up, Commander. You've got hostile contacts inbound.
Darius, what do you mean with inbound? You're just telling me all our enemies on the field of battle where we fight an enemy lands, then yes, you're totally right.
Okay. Heading out.
Let's see if we can do something fancy with this rock here, keeping it between us and some of the enemies.
Location confirmed.
Alright, that's a Black Knight. So I think the classical way to kill him is to
light damage, holding firm.
Take out both his arms and both his legs. Then it's a draw. Now the fact that the Black Knight moved in phase 3 from medium phase means that's a pilot with like the improved, better initiative thing. Anyway.
Ready to get it on.
Let's start with some sniping here, right? What do you have? Shufu-Din, Brishin shot. Okay. What kind of shots are that?
Firing full complement on the enemy. We got company.
Whoa. Excuse me. How's a 60-ton mech coming from that side? Not a fan of that. Uh, Right, that's a battle master. That's an assault mech. He is acting in phase one. Great. Yeah, there's enemy reinforcements. Okay, we're fighting 4 versus 8 here or something like that. That's just fantastic.
What's up, boss? Moving to position.
Now, they shouldn't be able to, well, unless they have to jump jets to come up this ledge. So maybe I can focus on these other guys here first. But yeah, overall, not a fan. Not a fan of all. Okay, I guess the only positive thing right now is that I think only one of those guys here shot with long-range missiles, so we can probably sort of, kind of ignore them. I don't even know. Okay, rocks.
What can I do for you?
We need some results here on against that Black Hawk, Black Knight. Kind of
another
okay.
Like that and you're toast.
I could go for a toast right now.
We can do this. Let's go.
One point of health on the center torso. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. Ah, the Thunderbolt sees us. I was going to say, let's just break line of sight. Kill that guy and then nobody provides vision. Can't really do that. Now, I'm just gonna stand here and give him, I don't know, 2 medium lasers. Let's give him 3 medium lasers just to be on the safe side.
Engaging target. Enemy mech destroyed. Warning. Enemy sensor lock detected.
Got something you want done? I get you. On the move.
And these shots are pretty bad, Mr. Kill. And you've got a little bit of a heat issue. Yeah, let's rather cool down a little bit. I'm gonna keep moving in the direction of this group there. Get some distance to those guys. I wonder if I should precision strike here. I think it's not super useful with the long range missiles. But it would make sure that our Battlemaster can act before he can act again.
Five.
Didn't she say something about, ooh, we're gonna do this lens on lens. A fair fight, you have my word. Oh, by the way, we bring twice the amount of people. Hope you have extra beer in the fridge. I don't think she said the stuff about the beer. Anyway, look at that heat that we have. This is disgusting. Who built this mech?
Coordinates received.
Heat levels are over 9,000. Is that large pulse even worth it? I mean, it has a good, pretty good chance to hit, okay. 20 heat. Compared to medium lasers, 10. So, probably not. Twice the heat for 50% more damage, but then again 25% more likely to hit, which on average, I don't know.
Here we go!
Okay, not enough for the Thunderbolt.
We can do this! Let's go!
I wish I could share your enthusiasm. Okay, it's a catapult, the Thunderbolt, and the Thunderbolt.
Waiting for orders.
Great. Can I not get 2 pips of movement without getting a bad shot? Yes, I'm fully aware that I'm totally moving my LRM mech into the middle here.
Moving out. Targeting for an alpha. One less target.
One fewer target.
They've got a lock on me.
Like, sensor locks at least don't do damage. Exposing my back to the reinforcement lands. Might not have been the smartest decision today. Come on, let's go for another head hunting here. Ooh.
Ready for orders.
Okay, you cannot get any direct shots on the cat.
Location confirmed.
Damage minor. Waiting for orders.
All right, let's bring you around here.
Right, Commander.
Question. You do not have Quad Shot Mastery, okay. So I don't think, no, I'm not gonna gamble on a 5% shot here. Don't precision strike, please. Okay, just strike.
Affirmative.
It's work to do.
Reporting minimal damage.
Okay, keep working that catapult. Flush the heat. You know what? I'm gonna go for precision strike. With all the weapons in range, and I just need a single little bit of head damage.
All weapons committed.
There we go.
Enemy mech destroyed.
Orders? Heading out.
I'm gonna save a little bit on heat. Now I have the kind of bad shot here.
Locking up.
Ouch. They're really coming around. I did not think he would get an angle on that. Oh well.
Commander?
Okay, let's not put our backside too exposed to the other enemies there. I kind of want to make sure. But I can't make sure because he has better initiative. I cannot act before he acts. Unless I take out a leg, which I don't have a damage for. Let's just save our resolve.
Copy that.
Commander?
Okay, rocks. Yeah, we got an 85 ton mech and we can shoot 3 medium lasers. I'm so happy that I have this thing here.
Firing on target.
And we missed 2 of those.
Come on, mech warriors. It's go time.
Yeah, I think that's gonna be the order of the day. Battlemaster punching things. But on our side, that's gonna be dress up by punching things.
Engaging physical attack.
Could have been better results, not gonna lie.
Ready for orders. Roger.
Are you gonna
scored critical hit.
Gonna fall down? Yes, you're gonna fall down. Alright, I'm gonna reserve with Morgan. Do the Battlemaster punch first and then see what's left.
Commander,
it's like 3 missiles that hit you.
Good to go.
Yes, I'm not sure what we hit there. Did he have fresh center torso and we hit that?
Aye, aye.
Think so. Okay, so they're all still coming around that side, right? Okay, then I think this is somewhat safe-ish. He also doesn't have Cold Shot Master. What kind of guys are these?
Copy that.
He's standing up. You're not supposed to do that. Okay, I think I can take another turn of low heat, so let's just punch him again.
Engaging physical attack.
Resilient little bugger.
Enemy mech, critical damage detected. Warning, enemy sensor lock detected.
I think this guy just needs to
copy that.
Needs to go away.
That hit something good.
What's that? That's again like here. Strange terrain, right? Okay, again, one more time. Reserve.
Reserving
let the Battlemaster do its thing. And then we'll see if Morgan needs to. It needs to try to be useful. Maybe we should just go in with him too and try to punch people.
On my way. Critical hit, Commander.
You gotta be friggin' me. Okay, Mr. Kellhound.
Heading out.
You know what? I'm not paying for the repairs of this mech, so why don't you do a little bit extra heat?
Time to unload. Hostile removed. I'm taking heat damage.
I guess you should have brought a better mech.
Watch my six.
Ooh, watch my six is not what I want to hear on that mech.
Internal structure damage. Ready for
get
order.
Out of there. Get, like, yeah.
Let's move.
Yes, Commander.
It's like, oh, you're gonna move? You're gonna take over, Heat.
I copy. Hey, I'm overheating.
You're not even doing anything. I'm gonna reserve here.
Standing by.
Okay, I think I'll just skip the bad shots here. Field. Add seat to units passing through. Yeah, I'll take a no on that. But if I want to have proper line of sight here.
Moving to position.
Okay, let's take the precision shot for initiative reasons, you know? Even if you don't have great chances. What is even in that torso? Not the ammo for the SM, but taking it.
That's a critical hit.
Commander.
Yeah, they are really having a hard time understanding how the map works, I think, so.
Firing a full salvo.
I think we can probably take them down one by one as they come around the corner.
Target's yeah? Taken a critical hit.
More or less. Okay, that's probably a Jaeger.
Warning, armor low.
Not what I want to hear. Not at all what I want to hear here. If you were to not move, just fire your LMs, you would actually reduce your heat. Fantastic. You're such a valuable addition to the Lance, Morgan.
Taking the shot.
Another Thunderbolt, and that's the Jaeger mech I was seeing before. We're on full resolve. I think I'm just gonna vigilance. Because I'm the only one they see, so everybody will shoot at me. What are you looking? That's what? 140-ish? Of course he survives with almost single-digit hit points. And he's like, nope, I'm out.
Good to go.
Okay, Roxy. It's not like you can do anything useful. Do I care about your initiative, Mr. Thunderbolt? Probably not.
Here we go.
Now, if I move, I already lose again my whole vigilance. Guarded, entrenched, reduced damage thing. So I'm thinking I'm just gonna reserve here.
Waiting for orders.
Okay, how about we do a multi-shot on that guy and on that guy? Don't fire the 20.
Roger that.
Standing by.
You can fire your single LM-10 and consider yourself to be useful.
Engaging target.
I mean, at least they all have breaching shot, so it's not completely pointless. Why are they not even taking shots right now? Are they just all focused on Kel and trying to hit him? Or more like focused on not hitting the guy who has cover up? I can reserve more. Move that freaking thunderbolt. Now we're talking. Okay. I'm gonna go get in there, get personal.
Engaging jump jets.
Heat vent. And precision strike. Let's chew through your center dozer.
All weapons committed.
Oh, wow.
Enemy mech destroyed.
I mean, I don't want to, like, pat myself on the shoulder here, but man, that was a good shot.
Affirmative. Right, Commander.
Okay, and he's moving that guy first. You fool. Didn't you see what just happened to your friend? Might not have the heat capacity to do that thing again, but we're damn sure gonna try. <laughs> 65 tons of scrap metal, huh? Alright, reserve that.
Waiting for orders.
Roxy.
Coordinates received.
Give me your assault mech sensor lock here. Oh, it's a Jaeger.
Waiting for orders. Affirmative.
There you go.
Receiving you. Roger that.
Heat is a bit of an issue. You know what? Let's take the breaching shot.
Locking on target.
What are you even doing?
Roger that. Standing by.
Got it.
I mean, we got the sensor lock on our side. We can do this all day long.
Got a lock.
Or rather, until you run out of
orders,
out of health, and for Jaeger mech, that happens pretty fast.
Affirmative.
Yes, Commander. Position confirmed.
Let's actually fire the 20 instead of the 15.
Engaging.
Kinda makes sense, right?
Critical hit, Commander.
Yeah, with my current heat levels, I have no problem playing that a little bit conservative, boring, safe.
Reserving action.
Sensors locked on.
Receiving you. Confirmed.
Right.
Roger.
Standing by.
You're gonna have such a bad day.
On it. Affirmative.
Oh, he's like toasty from all the sides, yeah.
Think I hit something good.
Should we go in for the mercy blow? Yeah, let's finish this. So where do you want it? You know what? I'm just gonna take out your side torso first. Carve you up like a turkey.
Engaging target. Enemy mech. Critical damage detected.
Alright, as I was saying, I'm taking out your side torsos. I hope you don't mind.
Enemy mech, critical damage detected.
What's he gonna do? Like, he can't come up here. That's your left, right leg. There's no way for me to hit that from that position.
Standing by.
Can I get a front arc shot? No, not really.
On the move. Roger that.
Ammo explosion on the center torso. That works. Nicely done. You punch above your weight. Color me impressed. Mission successful. Well, also tense fight. I complain always about Darius and his reinforcements. But then it's kind of an interesting thing having to fight a two front battle like that. Basically, I'm committing to one side or. Maybe it would have been better to commit to the other side. I mean, it went well, right, at the end of the day. Although, those were some, like, nerve-wracking hits, yeah. And that's... the Battlemaster was so useless. Like, all these energy weapons. I mean, okay. Probably a tough fight, like a tough competition, like who was more useless, the Orion or the Battlemaster? I guess he at least provided sensor lock. Anyway, salvage time. I'm definitely gonna pick up that Black Knight. And before I pick up anything else, let's see what we have down here. Triple plus large laser, but no great modifiers. Medium lasers are all kind of boring. Oh, there's a 10 damage small laser. Yes, please. Heat sinks. You want to have some heat sinks? We've got all the heat sinks in the world. Okay, mech parts. Can't go wrong with Thunderbolt, huh? Well, the only thing that could give us a complete mech would be actually the catapult. So let's take two parts and hope that the dice are on my side. They're not. Oh well, we'll get the last part sooner or later. Eventually, maybe. Now, so she didn't keep her word about fighting us lands on lands. Did she keep the word about returning the hostages? The Braying of Hounds, part 3. High Orbit Viribion. That was one hell of a fight. Shri is dead, and the beasts of Balawat have been scattered. Isn't what I'd have wanted for them, but their minds were set on vengeance. We gave them a blaze of glory to go out on instead. I suppose that's near enough to the same thing. What about Tempest and Megan? Are they okay? They will be. Re and her people were good to their word. I give them that much. Naturally, Tempest is furious about all of this, and I can't blame her. If she'd had access to anything she could have fought with them with, she wouldn't have needed my help in the first place. Even without a battle mech, she managed to kill three of them before she and Meng got captured. If Tempest had beaten Rion own, the Beast of Bala never would have gotten to take a swing at you. In my opinion, they deserve the chance. Don't get me wrong, Cal, I'm not condoning the murders or the hostage taking or any of the other terrible shit that we had pulled, but you did wrong those people. had a legitimate grievance. This was the only way they could figure to settle it. Yeah, no, I'm not seeing your point, Young. That's like, oh no, he ran away to a monastery. We have to murder a bunch of guys. No. The beast were Calhoun's ones, my own people. They deserve better than what I gave them, but what's done, it's done. Anyway, I'm near that. To a tune of the price we negotiated at the start of the soul debacle. You're receiving that pay, plus a bonus, you've earned it. Yes. Bonus. My favorite word. I put Meg and her mom onto the first transport to wherever they want to go, then I get back to Sania and return to a quiet life at the monastery. And I don't leave again without a damned good reason. My brother Patrick can go on running what's left of the hounds in my absence. They'd be better off without my baggage anyway. Absolutely. Companies like yours are few and far between. I won't forget that. Thank you, Morgan. Get better, Max. And it doesn't help that he hires us again. The man paid well. Well, let's see what the loot box says. A king crab part. A grasshopper part. An SM2. Medium laser of travel modifiers. I'm like, what's the bonus here so far? A heat bank. Alright, alright. Now we're talking. Never comp system. Injury resist cockpit mode. Okay. Like, that counts as a rare mech part. Or is that the regular King Crab, or is that kind of a special variant? Yeah, I don't know. I guess the heat bank is kind of nice. Everything else is kind of... eh. So, here we are. First of all, these are the contracts that are available here in the system. All garbage. So we're gonna fly away immediately. Having a quick look at the star map. We're here. Well, look at that. Next flashpoint waiting for us, just over there. So this is the unwelcome guests for fighting against China. Lost tech items as a reward. Short engagement, that looks interesting. Then we have this tournament thing here. Gladiator combat, something like that. Oh, Solaris Gladiator. Our pal Bradford. With a rare mech. Not parts, like a mech. A full mech. A rare mech. And the new flashpoint showed up here. Siegebreaker. Rare mech upgrade, whatever that means. And what I like about both of these is that we have light tonnage requirements. So it's not gonna be the Orion Party Part 2. Yeah, this is also with a light requirement. This one has no restrictions. And then eventually we get all the way back to headhunting. Oh yeah, 96 days. Probably has to be a straight travel from point to point if I don't want to miss any of the flashpoints. And you know what? I prefer the flashpoints, even though some of the writing is a bit cheesy. I prefer the flashpoints to the regular standard missions. I think that's more interesting, especially like now that we have a decently equipped mech bay. Of course, we need to repair all of that. To that, and then we have to, well, yeah, refit this. I think I'm not super convinced by this version, but I want to give it another shot. Like, I feel that was clearly my mistake of how I played him. Was too close to the heat. Yeah, so let's just confirm that.
Logged and noted. Shouldn't be too hard.
The other thing that's in progress, the catapult, that wasn't ready, even though we traveled for 44 days. So this is gonna be just a normal pure LM, two LM20 launches, just in case our Rainmaker is ever out of service. Yeah, and I think, okay, let's put you into storage. And the rest of the roster stays like that, so 355s, the 250s, the Hunchback, Raven, and for some reason I'm still keeping the Jenna around. Probably will have to go once we get into heavy territory, salt territory rather. Alright, yeah, as I said, I'm gonna fly to the next flashpoint. For some reason, the stores seem to be often empty when I get into systems. I don't know why that's happening. Could certainly sell a few things. Although I'm still not sure how the score is calculated with the whole have all max of different chassis in your barracks in your ship. I don't know. I mean, we're okay again in regards to funds. Final thing to have a quick look at: ship upgrades. So I did prioritize the third part of the training module. So this means we get. The pilots not in service get, any pilot gets 50 experience a day until they reach 30,000 experience total. I'm actually not sure if any pilot's still, gaining anything from that, but I hope it works. I also might just pick up another pilot so that we have a full roster of 8. We're working on the power systems here, so that we can get the next engine upgrade, which reduces our travel time. Then again, it's really just the travel time to and from the jump point. So from the planet to the jump point, not the individual jumps. So the majority of these long travels are just going to be the jumps. Like the 5 days at the start and at the end to get from the jump point to the planet is like, if you're just jumping a single system, sure, then that's the big thing, but if you're traveling across the galaxy, it's just jump after jump after jump, and you cannot skip the cutscenes for the jumps, and yeah, it's fun. Anyway, enough rambling from my side. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.